All right. Okay, so hi, Mary.
Good morning.
Just gonna mute you. Okay, so let's start seated. Find that nice tall seated posture, no collapsing, right? No rounding of the spine, but nice tall spine with natural curves. Shoulders relaxed away from your ears. Maybe close your eyes for a moment. Just feel your body in this moment. Connect to your breath. Notice where you hold a lot of tension. And hopefully some of that tension will be gone at the end. Just a few more breaths through your nose, nice and long. Letting the belly rise on the inhale. Excellent. And then you can open your eyes and let's lift the arms up and overhead, big stretch up. And then exhale, side bend. And back up and down. And side to side. Great. One more. Excellent. And back to center. And then we're going to interlace the fingers. And then try to straighten the elbows, push those palms forward. And then if it's okay for your shoulders, you can try lifting up, pushing the palms up towards the ceiling. Stay here for a few breaths. Lengthening the sides of the body. Try to sit upright. So try not to use the back of the chair. Yeah. And then exhale. Great. And then we'll do a few twists. So inhaling, lifting through the spine, and then twisting over to your left side, to your right hand on the left knee. And then stay there for a few moments. And then if it's okay for your neck, you can try looking over your right shoulder. So away from that side. And then hold it for a few moments. And back to center, other side. So still nice long spine, twist to the right. And then if it's okay for your neck, look over your left shoulder. Great. And back to center. Excellent. And then let's wake up the legs. So let's straighten and bend one leg 10 times. So try to really straighten through the knee and lift that heel as high up as you can. Work in the hip flexors and the quadriceps a few times. Pulling those toes up towards the ceiling. Hi, David. Nice, and then we'll switch sides, so other leg. All Excellent. And then to warm up the ankles, we're gonna lift the toes towards the shins and then lift the heels. And then we're trying to really do the biggest range of motion you can get. So lift those heels high, lift those toes high. Few more. If you can really feel the muscles on top of the shin engage as you lift those toes. And then as you lift the heels, you'll feel it. And the calves. Good. All right. And then to wake up the core, we'll do a few seated movements. So you're making yourself big, so spreading your limbs to the side. And then bringing them together, or for even harder, you can lift your feet off the floor and sort of curl up and then open and close, or like this. Open, close, open, close, open, close, open, close. Big stretch, open the fingers as you stretch to the side. Nice. Excellent. And then we'll go kind of like you're climbing on a ladder. So lifting that knee high and reaching with the opposite arm. Lift that knee. So you'll feel it in the hip flexors. Yes, good. Nice job. All right. And then we'll work on standing up from the chair and sitting back down. If you're having trouble with standing up, you could try to do at least a little bit of a butt lift and then just back down. Or the other option is to stay up and do squats. So maybe not coming as low as the chair, but this is a great exercise and we need it all the time, right? Sitting down. Standing up, very functional. So nice, big opening, big reach. Excellent. Let's do a couple more. So one. And up, and two, and up. Great. All right, and we'll stay up. I'll turn on the music, and while I do that, you guys can do some calf lifts. So either not holding on or slight touch on the chair, lifting your heels up and down. Waking up those calves. I'll share the music. You guys hear it? All right, let's start with a nice march. Every time the sun goes down, I let you take control. So moving the arms, possibly with the opposite leg, right? And then we'll flick the fingers open to the side. So you're spreading the fingers while you walk. Straighten those elbows. Open the palms. And then forward. Straighten forward. Excellent. Straighten those arms fully. Good. And then we'll do one more. We're going to go back. So you're opening the palms up. The arms back without rounding like this. So your chest is up and you'll feel it at the back of the arm. The tricep. Straighten those arms. Push back. Keep them back. Hold it. Back behind you. Engage those triceps. Excellent. Okay. And then crisscross them. Excellent. Good. And then we're going to do a wider stance. And I'll work on the weight shift. So reaching side to side. If you can, you could lift that leg up. Yeah, to add some extra hip strengthening. And then again, as you reach, open the fingers. Big movement. We're making everything big in this class. Good. And then we'll work on those big steps forward. Step forward together. A nice power up, which is this position with the arms and chest up. Nice big steps forward. Full step, so you're really relying on that front leg to help you, and then you push yourself back. Nice. And then we'll do only a tap. So your weight stays here, so you're not shifting forward, right? You're staying here and just sending the toes to tap in front of you. If you can't quite point the foot as much, you could do the whole foot, but don't step on it with the weight. Good, so it's even a little bit of a lean back, right? So you can send that foot forward. Nice. And then we'll go tap to the side. Good. And we'll add that opposite arm. So we're working on some movement patterns that use the opposite arm and leg. Great for the brain. Sometimes it gets confusing, so don't get too worried about it if you're messing up. It counts that your brain is trying hard. Excellent. Good. And then we'll still do this tap and we'll do same side arm and reach forward. So left limb, right limb. Just a little tap to the side. Nice. All right. Good. And then back to march. Mm-hmm. And then we'll touch the opposite knee. So again, across the body movement. Opposite knee touch. Hi, Alexa. Lifting that knee high up. Excellent. Great. Back to march. And then we'll lunge out to the side. So you're turning out that foot and reach to the right. Back to center. Reach to the left. Try to turn out that foot. So your external rotation of the hip. Side to side. Again, full step. Your weight bearing in that leg. Excellent. Good. And then we'll stay in the middle, so a little wider stance. Now we're going to throw some punches straight forward. Put some vigor into it. Soft knees. Great. And then we'll go for that cross. So you're adding a little rotation in the whole upper body. Good. Right. And then we'll do those uppercuts. From below up. Good. Nice. Good. And then we'll go in and then both feet go up. Both in, both out. Out, out, in, out, out, in. So extra wide. Out, out, in, out, out, in. Usually the outer out is a little hard for people. Doing your best. And it's not about perfection. A lot of weight shift, which is great to practice. So good for balance. Nice. Excellent. Great. And then maybe one more before we do the 15 exercises with the dumbbells. We're gonna try to tap at the heel. So you're pointing the toes up, maybe bending that standing leg a little bit as you tap. Great. Nice job. All right. So let's get ready. If you have those dumbbells, you can get them ready. Timer. Okay, so The first exercise, everyone ready? First exercise will be a squat. So when we do the squat, we're moving the hips back, right? So bending the knees, bend the movement back rather than knees forward too much, okay? And then as you come out of it, out of that squat, we're gonna try to do a lift. And then again, side and lift. So both leg and arm lift. Ready? We have 5 seconds to start. We work 45 seconds, we rest 15 seconds. All right, let's go. So squat and lift. Squat, lift. And you can always modify if your knees don't like too much squatting. You can just come to center without the squat. Halfway there. Those hips back and that squat. 10 seconds. Good, great, and rest. So the next one is the jacks, jumping jacks. So we do them this way. So you're sort of lunging out. With or without dumbbells. And you can, add some vigor to it, do it faster or slower. We're trying to aim for the vigorous exercise that's so good for our brain. Or you're working at least 70-80%. Of your power. Of course, if you get dizzy or unwell, stop. Don't push it if you can. Only 7 more seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. hopping, and then crossing possibly. If that's hard for your balance, you could hold on to the chair, or maybe don't go as far. And we can add some bicep curls. So bending at the elbows. You're a good soldier, choosing your battle. Pick yourself up and dust yourself off and back in the Another spiral. Option is to do just a side step, right? Instead of the cross. You know it's serious, we're getting closer, this isn't over. The pressure's on. Seconds. Excellent. And rest. So the next one is the power rock. Or possibly with the dumbbell. You're reaching to the side, rocking side to side. Rock side to side. Keep breathing. Go with the right leg forward and back. As you step forward, you're doing bicep curl. As you come back, triceps extension. So forward, back, same leg. And then halfway through, we'll switch. One leg is glued, the other one is working. All right, and then switch leg. So, other leg forward and back. This time for Africa. Excellent. And rest. And the next one. It's a march, wide march though. So you're sort of keeping the knees apart, feet apart. So you'll feel it a little bit in the hips. Wide legs. So lifting those knees up. Seconds. Excellent. And rest. All right, number 10. So heel lift and shoulder press. So you're gonna lift through the heels and lift the dumbbells up. And then back down and up, lift the heels and the arms. Up. Up. Those calf muscles, lift those heels, keep breathing. Get sweaty. Ten seconds. Excellent, and rest. Number 11, butt kickers and punches. So lifting the heel towards the butt and then opposite arm punches. So knees pointing down. Lift the heel back towards the butt. You can do it. Only 4.5 to go. Excellent. Halfway through this one exercise. Eight, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right. So the next one is a little bit less vigorous. We're just sliding into a side bend, but you're still using muscles, core muscles, right? So sliding that dumbbell down, rolling to the other side. Keep your feet down. Keep your feet down. It's just a movement in the upper body. See if you can slide that hand down towards your knee. Side of the knee. Now we're working the oblique muscles and then the QL muscles, quadratus lumborum in the back. Good. All right. And then it's a curtsy lunge for the side lift. Okay, so a little curtsy and then a lifting. Curtsy, curtsy. And as you lift those arms laterally, try to keep your shoulders down so you're not doing this, right? So it's like that. So shoulders stay away from your ears. So you're working these deltoid muscles, not these muscles, the upper traps. And then she kissed me like there was nobody else in the room. As last orders were called was when she stood on the stool after dancing to Kaylee singing to track. Ooh, it's tiring. Or those arms. All right, we're done. Almost. Two more. So the next one is quick feet again. And we still have 8 seconds to rest. All right. And go for it, big feet. Closing time, I was holding a hand, a hand was holding mine. Our coats both smell as halfway through. We fill up her lungs with the cold air of the night. I walked her home, then she took me inside to finish some Doritos and another bottle of wine. I swear I'm gonna put you in a song that I write about a go-away girl and a perfect night. She played the fiddle, got that hot rate up. But she fell in love with an Englishman. Kissed her on the neck and then I took her by the hand. And rest. And last one. We're gonna twist and punch, okay? So you still have 10 seconds rest. Nice deep breath. Ready, set, go! So pivoting on that foot. Nice big twist to the side. Look to the side. Take that hip with you. Excellent. Halfway through. Only 20 seconds left. Hey. 6, 4, 3, 2, 1. Excellent. Give yourself a clap. Get some water. All right, we're done with the hard part. some wrist circles with your back. All right. And then we'll do a white stance. You're gonna bend that right knee, draw a big circle, and then other side, facing the other side. So cross the body. Excellent. Nice. And then we'll go side to side with the hips. So soften your knees. And then take your pelvis to the side. Bend. And then a big circle with those hips. And reverse. Excellent. And let's step forward to the right leg. You can be pretty wide, you know, kind of like you're on train track for better stability. The front knee bend, back leg straight, back heel down. And then we'll reach across like that. One, and then you're gonna sort of lean forward, lifting that back heel, pushing, and then coming back down with that heel and pulling. Push, pull, push, pull. Step back through that heel. What do you mean? And then one last one here. We're gonna go hinging at the hips, so nice long spine. You're not rounding, but hinging at the hips and then reaching towards the floor, kind of like you want to pick up something and then push it up, pull it up towards the chest. Reach down. And as you reach down, try to keep the shoulders back so you're not rounding the shoulders, but keeping them back. Engaging the upper back muscles that squeeze the shoulders back. Don't know if you're happy, you're complaining. Don't want for us to win. Where do I start? First you wanna go to the left, then you wanna turn right. Nice, all right. And then we'll switch legs. So your other leg forward, front knee bent, back heel down. And we'll start with a cross reach. Excellent. And then we'll do that push, lifting that back heel and bring that back heel down, pull, push, pull, push, pull. So all these exercises are great for your balance. So you're practicing moving the center of gravity. Good. And then we'll go, again, hinging at the hips. We'll go down and pull it up. What do you mean? Those shoulders back. So chest is lifted. running out of time, what do you mean? Excellent. Good. And I love to do jazz hands. So this movement, right? So you can do it slower or fast. Supination, supination in the arm. Good. Great. And then we'll work the fingers a little more. So you're gonna keep the big the thumb and the pinky together, and then open the rest of the fingers. Stretch them, stretch them, stretch them as far apart as you can. So the heels of the palms together, and then yeah, that's it. And then back together. Do it one more time. Inhale and open. Yeah, that's it. That's it. So you're feeling the engagement in the extensors, right, of the fingers. Good. Nice. And then maybe with the rhythm, you can try touching each finger with the thumb. And then you can try quick or slower. Each finger. Excellent. And then big clap to the side with a nice rotation. Good. And then one more, a little bit for the brain. So your right arm will be number one, left arm number two, right leg number three, left leg number four. Okay? So now we're gonna do 1, 3, 4. Right, left, right hand. Your right arm. 2, 3. Right leg. And 1. Sit. 3, 4. Good. And then we'll do 2 at the same time, okay? So we'll do 1 and 3. That's it, same side. And 2 and 4. And then 1 and 4. Excellent. 2 and 3. And 4 and 1. 3 and 2. 1, 2. And 3, 4. Nice. And 1, 2, 3. Nice. And 4, 2, 1. And 1 and 3. Yes. 2 and 1. And 3 and 4. And 1, 2, 3, 4. Great. All right, okay, let's go down a little bit. Great job, guys. All right, do a little bit stretching and then relaxation. So before we go down, let's do a downward dog, either with your hands on the chair and stepping away. On the seat, or if you want to be a little higher, you could be here at the back of the chair. You could also use a wall, so hands on the wall or on the table. Just we're trying to lengthen the back. So you're pulling the hips away from the hands. creating that nice long line with your back, with your arms. You're hinging at the hips. So try to even out those curves in the back. Breathe. Excellent. And then slowly come up so you don't get dizzy. Great. And then we're gonna come down onto the mat. Unless you wanna stay in the chair, and that's fine too. So if you are up for coming down, you can start by slowly coming down and then hugging both knees into your chest. If you're seated, just hug one at the same time, at the time. So hugging both knees into your chest and then rocking side to side, massaging your low back. And then add some ankle circles with both feet. So circle those ankles. Make sure you're going to the side as well, that you're not just doing pointing and flexing, but the whole circle. So pointing sideways, flexing sideways. And reverse, go the other direction. Right. Okay, and then bring your arms down, so your palms down on the floor. And we're gonna do the toe taps. So your core is engaged. You can either do one leg at a time. So tapping maybe with your toes or heel on the floor, a little bit away from your butt. The further away you are, the harder. Or you could do both legs at the same time, if that's okay for your back. So bringing the knees into your chest, and then tapping them down, or one leg at a time. So as you're approaching the floor, right, your core has to engage to stabilize your back. And so that's where we're strengthening the deep belly muscles. Yeah, your head is resting, shoulders are resting. Good, nice job. And then take a little break. And then we'll keep the knees and feet together, and then we'll go side to side with the knees. So arms are out to the side, shoulders stay down. So you're just moving the lower part of the body mostly. I mean, the hip rolls over too. And you might feel a little bit of a stretch in the low back, depending on how low you go. So only go as far as it feels okay for your body. To make it harder, you could lift your feet off the floor and do it like a more strengthening rather than stretching. Good, yeah, so side to side, keeping the shoulders down, stabilizing through the core. Good. Okay. And then we'll do one more strengthening exercise, and that's just biking. So you're gonna be biking with your legs, and I'm gonna measure 1 minute. So let's see. Watch, ready, set, go. So go for that bike ride. If you're seated, that's a little hard to do, but you can march or you can do it one leg at a time. Keep the core engaged. And you're about halfway through. Keep biking, keep biking. And then reverse, go the other direction for the last 15 seconds. Nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. You're done. Great. And then take some deep breaths, relaxing your abdominals, your low back. Deepening the breath. So maybe while you do that, you can slowly move the head side to side. So stretching the neck. So roll the head over to the right and then to the left. Just slowly with the breath, mindfully. Just looking side to side. Or not just looking, but moving the head. Yeah. Moving the head side to side. Great. All right. And then come into the center, find a comfortable position, and we'll do relaxation. I'll be guiding you through a body scan. So this is an important part to sort of create more mindful connection to your body, to the parts of your body. So we're gonna, and we're also practicing focus, right? These guided meditations are great for improving focus. So try to stay focused on the part of the body I'm naming. So bringing awareness into your toes. And the soles of your feet. And your heels. And your ankles. Your shin, your calves, your knees. And your thighs. And your pelvis. Your belly. Your low back. Your chest. Your upper back. Your shoulders. Your arms. your hands. And then become aware of your face, softening the muscles in the face. And then become aware of your whole body. Your whole body relaxing and softening. And then take a deep breath and slowly start moving your fingers and toes. Maybe take a stretch. And when you're ready, you can roll over to your side and slowly find your way to sitting. Hello there, new faces. Welcome, welcome. I hope you enjoyed the class. If you have any questions, you can always email me. You should have my email, I think, from the class registration. It's my last name, fibrikova@gmail.com. I like to close the class with a little sort of intention setting. My background is a yoga teacher. So I think the mind, we have to get the mind on board too with, you know, these intention settings. So I think it's a nice practice. So you can join me, but you don't have to. So feel free to repeat after me. May I be happy. May I be healthy. May I be mindful. May I have courage. May I have fun. And may I treat myself and others with love and compassion. And then hands to your forehead as a reminder of the power of your thoughts. Hands to your lips as a reminder of the power of your words. And hands to your heart as a reminder of the power of your actions. Great action today. Nice job, everyone. So again, before you leave, I will be gone for visiting my family in Czech Republic. So the next class won't be until January, I believe it's 10th. Or what did I say, 9th or 10th. So I'm leaving actually tomorrow. So have great holidays. You can use the videos. I'll add you to my list and I send the recordings to your email addresses that you provided. So, and you can also find it on PD Active YouTube channel. All right. So,
okay, Petra, have a great trip. Enjoy the holiday and we'll see you in the new year.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for the class.
And everybody else, have happy holidays.
Thank you.